Hi guys, in this session we will see about some CSS properties. So what is a CSS properties? Cascading styles. Okay, if you want to add some styles for your front end HTML or any other HTML related tags, then you have to go for CSS. Actually, CSS is a style oriented library where you want to define the properties and the values for the particular HTML. Okay, so let me quickly jump into the program. Okay, so here I am having this, I just started this HTML. This is like a sample css.html I have taken. So in this at very first point, I have given here a header tag, and then I gave here h1 and I gave here body tag, right? So I just want to give some styles for my div or something, right? So I have just started one para. Let me go for para at very first, and I am going to give here like a sample CSS. Okay, in para. Okay, so that will be more specific. So now if I want to check this CSS, how to check this, you have to go for this HTML and you have to run this HTML in the Google Chrome. Okay, so once you are running that in the Google Chrome, you will be finding like this. Okay, see, sample, the first one is like h1 sample css sample. I can go for this header, right? So if I save this and I can refresh this, I will find the output here. And I am having a sample css in para, so that is the one which is this para, right? Yeah. So I just want to go for a style tag. So style tags in general, you will use the style tags inside the header, right? Inside the head. Okay, so in this head I am going to start a style. Okay, so I just want to start with one para, right? Yeah. So once you are giving the p here, obviously it will go and fetch the para element. Okay, the para element. Okay, and I am giving here color, I am giving here some red. Okay, so, and also I just want to give some color text align. So text align will make like whether the text is in the center or left or right. So that kind of properties it will give. Why it is showing still white means I have to give here semicolon after every property declaration, right? So this syntax will be in the format of, okay, property and colon value. Okay, all the time this syntax will be in the format of property and value. Okay, here my property is color and the value is red. What about the line number 7? The property is text align line and value is center, right? So let us quickly jump and see this output. Okay. Yep, so I can able to find the text align in the center, and also I can able to see the color as red. Always colors mentions the font color, don't confuse with the background color. Background color is different, font color is different. Okay, so here we have just kept one para tag, and then I gave one property as color and one more property as text align center, right? So let me see one more example of these selectors. Okay, so in this we have like, so first of all, this is like a general selector. We have one ID selector. ID selector uses the ID attribute of HTML element to select a specific element, actually to fetch a particular element. The ID tag will be used, and ID tag of an element is unique within the page. So the basic ID tag, like it will tell that it in this page I am only the one, I am the unique. Okay, you cannot define two ID tags with the same name. So ID selector is used to select one element at a time. Okay, it is a one unique value. Okay, to select an element with a specific ID, you have to mention in the format of hash character. Okay, so for example, I have here my para tag. Okay, that I want to give here some ID over here. Okay, so let me quickly give some ID here. Space ID. So let me go for some para one, or some para I gave here, para. Okay, so this para, whatever I am giving here, it will be in the format of hash para, right? So now you can find this value as blue, right? Center, okay, text align center. So I have saved that, and I just want to see this, right? So likewise, you can able to create your own para ID tag ID, but you have that ID should be unique in your web page, and also this para tag should be mentioned with hash para hash symbol in the style. Okay, so that's one of the selector. Okay, that's one of the selector we can see. And some more is like, we have class selector. It will select the HTML element with a specific class attribute. To select an element within a specific class, you have to mention in the styles with dot. Okay, dot parameter represents the particular class name. For example, if I want to check like this, I am going to start like this with the, okay, here para I give, but I am giving here class. Okay, so this is a para class, right? So yeah, and here I am giving para class. Okay, denotes by dot in styles. Okay, so how do I denote, how do I refer this class name in styles, means with dot symbol, right? Dot para class. Okay, so here I am giving here text hyphen align, and I am giving here center, and I am giving here color some color I gave, sandal brown color I gave. So just want to go ahead and then check. Yeah, so para tag denotes by dot in styles. Okay, this is a different entity, and that is a different entity. Okay, so after this ID and class parameters, I am going to select I am going to one different selector, that is universal selector. Okay, whether we are having any whatever the elements we are having in the HTML page, that will be applicable for the entire page, entire elements. So let us think you are having some header tag in this body. So let me go ahead and then put here some header tag. So I have one header tag h1 and welcome to CSS again. Welcome to CSS again. And here one more para I have, but I am not going to give any para this time. I just want to go ahead and then comment all of them, right? So this is called universal selector. So with this universal selector, whatever the elements we are having in the HTML, all will be updated with the properties whatever we are mentioning here. Suppose I am giving here as a star and I open the brackets and I give here some kind of green color or something, and I definitely want to give end this statement with semicolon. And the next is the property. I am going to take one property, text align. I am going to give here left. Okay, so I have here header tag, I have here para, and I have here para class. Okay, I just want to check what is the output now. So you can able to find here all this HTML para, and also this everything became. See, this is the first one, first CSS header, and welcome CSS, and sample CSS in para, and para class denotes by star styles. Okay, so this star selector or universal selector is used to select all the elements in the HTML page. Okay, so if you want to group only some specific elements, so let us think you want to group only some specific elements. So I just have here some h1 and h2 p tags, right? So I just want to go ahead and then do only for h1 and only para tag, or only for h2. I am going to include one more tag here, that is some h2 tag, and with this h2 tag, welcome to, within that I am giving some text here. Okay, so with now I want to give this for only some specific elements. So I just want to give for only h1 and p. okay, so at that point of time I am going to comment this one, because I will be sending this it will be useful for us sometime. So h1, I am going to have here h1, and I am going to have here para. Okay, so I am going to give here color and I'm giving you some green hello, and I'm going to give here some text align again. Okay, so I'm going to give here this time left. Okay, so only the h1 and p tag, okay, only the h1 and p tag will become applicable for these properties, means color as green yellow and text align as left, right? So let me go and quickly go and see this, right? Yeah, so you can find now a part of this header too, or a part of this header too, all this became green yellow. So likewise, these are the five different selectors. The first thing is you can go for in class, and if you can either you can go for an ID, or you can go by an element wise, or you can give two elements at a time. To here our element is h1 is one element, h2 is one element, para is one element. Okay, So if I want to give only for specific element, I can give. If I want to give for only if I want to give group of elements, I can give. And also if I want to apply the properties for all the HTML tags, I can give with this universal selector. And also if I want to give for a via class, okay, I can able to mention with class, and then it will be denoted with dot. It will be denoted with a dot. And also I am going to have here para tag, which is like hash, which would be denoted with hash and style. So these are the all CSS simple selectors, all CSS simple selectors what we are having. Okay, so kindly take this as a practice. I will be sending you this GitHub link too. Thanks for watching.